My name is Dipna Anand. I'm chef, restaurateur here at Dippin' Brilliant. It's great being based right next to Chelsea Football Club. The clientele is different. I keep saying they're a bit harder to please over these sides, but it's great because it gives my staff and it gives myself a challenge, because with a name like Dipping Brilliant, it's quite daring, and you have to be, Gordon Ramsay explained this really well, with a name like Brilliant, you have to be nothing less than brilliant. So we have to ensure that we meet all their expectations, and that's not just giving them great food, but it's the atmosphere, the whole vibe, the service, and just general ambience of the place as well. Those who dine with us, we have started noticing they are coming back, so I think we're doing a good job. Keema peas is one of my grandfather's recipes. I was taught how to make this by my father. It's one of my favourite dishes, and it's much loved favourite of the Brilliant as well. So customers who dine with us for the first time and order a keema peas, they are looking to order that dish again because it's much enjoyed. It can be enjoyed with not only a naan bread or a chapati or a bhatura bread to pair with the keema peas, but you can also have it with a side of rice as well. So it goes with many things. It's one of those dishes that you can't go wrong with. So this is one of the traditional Indian curries. So when we are cooking keema peas, we start by using a base of onions, cooking the onions in the oil. And this is a really important step because when you cook your onions in the oil, it's important you cook them not so they're see-through or they're golden brown. We're looking for them really to be caramelized, and that's one of the crucial steps in Indian cookery. Once your onions are caramelized, you can then go in with your ginger garlic, your green chilies, and then your plum peel tomatoes or your fresh tomatoes, depending on what you're using. And that's your base. Cook that masala until it sizzles, and once the oil starts to seep out the edges, you then go ahead and you add your mince. Once you've added your mince, it's just a matter of cooking off that mince. You're adding the peas, and then your finishing touches like your garam masala and fresh coriander, two things that always go in at the last minute, because garam masala, you want to retain all that flavor, especially when you're making a curry. And it should take about 25 to 30 minutes if you've done it properly. Keema peas is presented either in a karai dish traditionally, or here we serve it in a small little saucepan with a little handles. It's served with a nice bhatura bread, because I think it pairs most amazingly with the bhatura bread, or a naan bread, and then some rice on the side as well. So bhatura, rice, keema peas. The mince that you add into the masala sauce is not seasoned, it's just raw mince. And then you have a little bit of a job because you're using your arms to break down the mince, but then all the flavor of the mince is releasing into the masala. So you get the oils from the lamb, the fat from the lamb, which is immersing into the masala sauce. And once all those flavors combine, you know you're gonna have the most perfect dish. Lamb works amazingly in a keema peas dish, and it's one that's quite traditional as well. So keema peas has been around for years. It was, this recipe is my grandfather's recipe, but Punjabi food and Punjabi cuisine, keema peas is a known dish. It's always just being cooked with lamb mince. Most people that come to a Punjabi restaurant and order keema peas will kind of know what to expect, a lamb mince dish. Here it's a little bit different because it's not just a dry lamb mince curry. Ours has a little bit of sauce to it. And I often see lots of people with their phones out taking pictures of the dish. And that's always a good sign, because if you like what you see and find it appetizing, then you want to dig in straight, or should I say dip in straight away.